robotic total abdominal hysterectomy with bilateral salpingectomy and pelvic node dissection on a Da Vinci system. Presented by Dr. Somashekhar SP, Head of the Department and Consultant Surgical Oncologist, Manipal Comprehensive Cancer Centre, Bangalore. A 40-year-old premenopausal female presented with post-coital bleeding since 3 months. There were no significant comorbidities. On per-vaginal examination, there was nothing significant. Per speculum revealed a 1x1 cm ulceroproliferative lesion in the anterior lip of cervix. Bilateral parametrium and fornices were free. MRI and ultrasound were not contributory. Biopsy from the cervical lesion revealed it to be a squamous cell carcinoma, stage 1B1. Hence, surgery was planned and patient worked up. The following diagram represents the port placement technique done by us for approaching a total abdominal hysterectomy. Camera port is taken approximately 2 finger breadths above the umbilicus in the midline, while R1 and R2 are mirror images in the subumbilical region in the right and left quadrants. We take R3 approximately 2 cm above and lateral to the anterior superior iliac spine, while assistant port is triangulated between camera and R2. We prefer a centroside technique of docking, which facilitates weak air manipulation by the assistant from the center. We start our initial dissection from the right pelvic lymphadenectomy. Sentinel lymph node mapping was done using Firefly technology by indocyanine green dye. The following diagram is of relevance in the proposed surgery, wherein the pararectal paravesical spaces as well as the branches of internal iliac artery, especially the uterine artery, is of importance. We start our dissection from the right side, wherein after opening the peritoneum, we are first able to detect the ICG-based fluorescent sentinel lymph node on the right common iliac region. The lymph nodal packet along the common iliac vein is also being excised. Here the normal anatomical relationship between bladder, uterus and sigmoid colon is shown. After mapping the sentinel lymph nodes from the right side, we then approach towards the left side. Here, the important ligaments like infundibulopelvic and round ligament are shown along with the tubes. After opening the left lateral peritoneum and the broad ligament area, we then approach towards the region of external iliac and common iliac lymph nodes. The entire region of the common iliac artery is being shown to be exposed and the lymph nodal packet removed. On the right side, the right paravesical space is shown to be opened up. Above, we are able to see the fibers of levator ani muscle along with the endopelvic fascia. Below is the uterine artery. The uterine artery is seen to separate the pararectal and the paravesical spaces. Now, we are opening up the pararectal space. the lower limit of dissection on the right side is the circumflex iliac vein, along with the genitofemoral nerve and psoas muscle is being shown. The entire lymph nodal packet on the right side bearing the right external iliac artery is shown. Obturator nerve is also visualized, wherein we take the obturator group of lymph nodes also. We start with the hysterectomy part. Since we have decided to do only salpingectomy and preserve the ovaries, we would be preserving the infundibulopelvic, that is the suspensory ligament of ovary. The ovarian ligament is shown to be ligated. This preserves the blood supply to the ovaries, which comes from the infundibulopelvic ligament. Similarly, on the right hand side also, we would preserve the ovary. Hence, after separation of the right ovarian ligament, we are preserving the infundibulopelvic ligament. Here, the uterine artery is shown to arise from the hypogastric artery, which then continues to form the obliterated umbilical artery. Similar to the right side, we are approaching the left side also. The entire lymph nodal packet in the obturator group as well as the iliac group is bare. Similarly, we open up the pararectal and paravesical spaces also on the left side. The uterine artery along with the obliterated umbilical artery is clearly seen. Then we take down the uterosacral ligaments, which are situated on the posterior aspect. Here we do a posterior colpotomy. Ureters on both sides should be carefully preserved. Before doing the lateral dissection completely, we would like to go for anterior and posterior colpotomy first, and then take the uterine arteries bilaterally. This decreases the chances of injuring the ureters. Now, anterior colpotomy is being shown. Then the uterine artery region on both sides is taken down. Hence, the entire specimen can now be delivered per vaginum. Vaginal wall closure is shown. Total blood loss in the procedure was around 75 ml, while time taken was 200 minutes. Consult time was around 50 minutes. Patient recovered from the procedure well and discharged on post-op day 1. Histopathology revealed it to be a squamous cell carcinoma of cervix and 2 out of 20 nodes on right and 1 out of 25 on left positive for malignancy. Hence, patient was given adjuvant chemo radiation and is on a regular follow-up. Thank you.